I'm actually dying right now because the Spotify Wrapped came up today. I don't know if you participate in that, but it took all, I listened to Hamilton so much that it just split all of the artists. And
it's so classic. I love that.
That's my warm-up day. If I haven't talked to anyone yet, I listen to Hamilton and just sing along to like warm up my vocals. That's my
okay. Honestly, that's a really good vocal warm-up, and I'm proud that you know that.
Oh my gosh. That was my introduction to Ariana. And now West Side Story. Congratulations on the movie. It is fantastic. It's such like an iconic thing, West Side Story. Do you remember the first time you saw it or it entered your life and what you thought of it?
Oh, I was sitting in, you know, my Nana's living room watching the woman in the purple dress just twirl with beautiful abandon. I thought she kind of looked like me. And I was like, oh, I want to do that. You know, so, and those were in my formative years. So it was like the doors were beginning to open in as far as my imagination of like what potentially I wanted to do with my life, you know? And then I found dance and now I'm here. So like West Side Story has just been like this for a long time.
Yeah, I first came across West Side Story when I was, I think, 12 years old. I saw the Broadway production in 2009. Mm-hmm. And I just fell in love with the music. I fell in love with the characters, the story, the dancing. There was just so many different aspects of it that I loved. You know, I remember coming out of that show and really wanting, you know, hoping that one day when I get older, I could do a West Side Story.
Wanted to be Bernardo.
So it's pretty awesome how it turned out. Yeah. And I'm sitting here right now to
manifest nation. That's what that is.
I love hearing that because, David, I heard they really had to track you the heck down for this movie.
Yeah, I was kind of, I was backpacking Mexico for 3 years almost. And I had just kind of taken a break from acting and theater and just everything. I don't know why. I just wanted to.
Because you could.
Why not?
Why not?
And then I saw a message on my social media from Cindy Tolan saying if I was interested in sending in a self-tape for the Steven Spielberg movie. And, you know, I was weirded out. I'm like, why, why me? All right, I guess so. You know, I'm gonna send it. I have zero expectations, but I felt something in me was just like, just send it, just do it. And I sent it and my whole life changed after that. So
I love that. Crazy. You can't win if you don't play. Yeah. So clearly play.
That's amazing. Cause I feel like, you know, when I get like mysterious DMs, I'm like, oh God, like what is this going to say? Yeah. But you have one, Steven Spielberg would like to talk to you.
Wild. Yeah.
Best DM ever. Ariana, you are fantastic in this film. Oh my God. And just, you know, Rita Moreno being a part of this film as well. She has such a larger than life personality. What sticks out to you about meeting her and the first kind of few interactions that you two had?
Oh, our first interactions were epic. Awkward because I was a bundle of anxiety. That's what sticks out to me about that. And you know, and thank the Lord she sort of could see through that and that it was just nerves because I cared. So she was very gracious with me and empowered me to lean into everything that makes me unique, you know? And I'm very, like I said, very grateful for that and having the opportunity to observe her on a set and see how she, you know, moves and on a set, how she relates to people. I love the way that she tells a story. Story time with Rita Moreno is like the greatest hour of life. Yeah.
With a hot chocolate.
Just listening. But I'll say having the opportunity to play a scene with her, in fact, it wasn't nerve wracking. I was very calm, which I don't know if that's like a rational thing, but I was calm. I think it was actually more nerve wracking for her. She's since said that it was hard for her to fully be in the scene because she still felt very much like she was Anita, but she was Valentina, you know? Right. I can't imagine what that must feel like. But for me, I just was so focused on playing the truth of the moment and I could feel how important it was that she was in the scene, that her being was represented in this scene. And it brings up, you know, an interesting, you know, what do you call, like a confrontation? Yeah. Between two Latinas of different generations, of different lived experiences. And I'm really glad that Tony Kushner kept that in the script. because I think it's a really iconic moment in and of itself.
I was looking for what the potential note was last night. I don't know. Something she told you to do in a scene.
Well, okay. So let me clarify. So the note would have been about a line delivery, right?
I thought it might have been the boxing, like do it harder than Bernardo would have.
Nope. That was me.
Yeah. Yeah. She was just like, yeah, get out of here.
Boom.
Jesus.
Oh, God. I know. I was boxing at the time. I boxed in order to prepare for the role because I just wanted Anita to feel really strong and quick on her feet. You know, I mean, she's dating a boxer, a very good one. So she might as well know how to throw a punch, too. So, yeah, that was kind of
fun. Love how they made your punches louder than mine. Boom, boom. Like, come on.
Well, they were louder really in real life. Yeah.